Hi friends, today I'm going to show how to connect to the internet in really difficult conditions. Because of the military operations in Luhansk, the power supply was deliberately cut off. That's why there was no mobile network available. We tried lots of ways of connecting to the internet and found three the most effective ways. The first one is to connect to Russia 3G internet. The second is connecting to Intertelecom internet. And the third one is to connect to GPRS by means of an old cell phone. We use these antennas for these ways of connecting to the internet. A wave channel antenna, a big watt antenna, a CAN antenna, a PIN antenna, and a dipole antenna. Now let's take this big watt antenna with the reflector. Since there is no 3G internet in Ukraine and Luhansk is next to the Russia's border, we decided to connect to Russia 3G internet. We connected lots of antennas to this connector. Almost each cell phone has got one. I used this antenna to connect to 3G internet. In this video, you can see how to make this antenna, which is for 2.5 GHz Wi-Fi signals. This schematic shows how to make an antenna which can connect to 3G internet at 1800 or 2100 MHz. We attach to this antenna to the cell phone. Then you can get up on the roof and try to connect to the internet. Turn the antenna through 20 degrees to the right. Now turn it through 5 degrees to the left. Update the data. Okay, it's updated. We've got a strong signal, it's okay now. You can go down. Since there are lots of wireless networks, you need to select a network to connect. It's only for territories near border. In case if you don't want to spend a lot of time on the roof, you can turn on portable Wi-Fi hotspot mode. The cell phone will enable other devices to connect to the internet. This way of connecting proved to be good in terms of its speed. This speed enables watching HD videos and even watching TV online. The second way, when power supply isn't cut off, you can try to connect to Intertelecom internet, but its base stations are too far away. That's why we have no choice but to come up with a new idea. We decided to go to buy an antenna in a shop. Let's choose a 10 cm antenna. Low frequencies interfere with TV frequencies. The frequency of Intertelecom internet is 800 MHz. That's why we can use a TV antenna. We can use a RG cable. Try to avoid screwing and soldering, it weakens the signal. You can lose up to 2 decibels, so we took the jack out of it and soldered it directly to the circuit board. It's also important to keep it polarized. You need to set the antenna vertically. This way of connecting has lots of advantages. The low frequencies enable the wave bounce of the obstruction they meet. You can connect to the internet even if you're 30 kilometers away from a base station. The internet speed really made me rejoice. It's really high speed. The only disadvantage is antenna size. You can't put it into your pocket or go for a walk with it. If you don't have money for a modem and all shops closed, then it's really a high time to try to find an old cell phone with a high power antenna. You can use such cell phones as old Nokia, Samsung, Siemens, Sony Ericsson with external antennas. I chose Samsung out of all these cell phones. Its antenna proved that this cell phone is really a reliable one. In this particular case, the size has to be little bigger. Here is the size of an antenna which is designed to receive signals of 930 and 1800 MHz frequency. Let's connect the cable to the computer and start using it. This way of connecting has some disadvantages. The speed didn't even reach 1/10 of a megabyte. On the other hand, it proved to be really reliable. When we couldn't connect to one of the network operators, we could simply change the SIM card and connect to another one. How do you connect to the internet? Share with us in your comments. Tell your friends about us, subscribe for our channel, click the like button and also watch our videos.